I found this exciting new program to use to be able to put textures on DAZ figures. It's been out for a while, but I just found out about it now, and I kind of want to share it with you. As you see, that is a Genesis 8 figure with a zombie texture on it. I'm going to show you how I achieved this. First off, a couple of things. I have a NVIDIA 1060 6GB. I was able to run this program. It's called Stable Projectorz. And I was able to run that on my PC. However, I was not able to run OBS to be able to record the footage. So I took some screenshots, and I'll kind of share my workflow with you real quick. So the first thing I did goes to DAZ Studio, load in a Genesis 8 model. And then once we have that Genesis 8 model in, a couple little things, do some morphs or whatever, kind of get the character a little bit how you want it. That way the images that we put over those or the textures we put over those will take in account some of the bumps, some of the, whether it's muscle definition or anything like that. So kind of get that stuff done first. And then we're going to go down to the surfaces tab. We're going to right click on that and we're going to do what's called a texture atlas. So when you right click, and I didn't get a picture of this, but you right click it, it gives you an option for texture atlas. And then it brings up all the textures that we have for the Genesis 8 figure. And it's going to take and put that on one UV map, which is going to be important in Stable Projectorz. So here I have kind of how I have it set up. I get rid of the eye moisture and the eyelashes. We don't need those. In fact, I probably should have, or I should have taken those and deleted those off the figure, but it really didn't hurt anything in the end. And then I made the face map and the torso map a two weight. I did the mouth, the eye moisture, and the cornea at 0.5. And then in the end, that's going to give us enough definition, I think, on the most important parts that we want to have a lot of definition on. I would even suggest what I've done in the past, too, is make the face just a little bit smaller and the torso a little bit bigger because the torso gets spread out over a larger area. So that's kind of important. And then we take an accept back here. There's an accept button down at the bottom. And then we're going to go into here and we're going to set it up. I try to put the UV settings or this UV map in the same spot. I'm going to put all of my other files for this project and switch it to 8192 by 8192, which is going to, for the most part, keep the face and the torso at about 4K and some of these other parts, which to me, I don't need as much definition of the legs and the arms. They're going to be a little bit smaller. So yeah, so then to hit accept on that. And then that's going to put all of the different textures for the character into one UV map. And then the next step on that is to export our character as an OBJ. Now, pay attention to this. And I'm not entirely sure why, but this is the setup that works best for me when I'm exporting the OBJ, in particular, the right separate objects off. And it makes it so that there aren't as many. Let's just put it this way. I will show you later once we get into Stable Projectorz why it's important to turn the right separate objects off. Okay, so I launched Stable Projectorz. I will have a link in the description below on how to or where to go to install this. I'm not going to go through the installing this. You'll just have to do that on your own. But we have this nice little UI here. It brings us this little door thing right here, which is what they use for the videos for the tutorial and all that, which is really cool. So once we get in this, we're going to go to this little 3D tab there. And we're going to use that to upload our OBJ. And if you notice, it's got all these. It's got arms, cornea, ears, blah, 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 all that type of stuff. If we had not done the, unclicked the separate objects, it would have had like three times as many different things. It would have split the like torso up into like five or six different objects or whatever. And this would be just an absolute cluster. We don't want that. So now that we have the character in there, we're going to go here. And we're going to go to control nets. You'll see that on there. And we're going to do preprocess none. And then there should be a depth model. I believe if I remember right, it was already in here when I installed the program. But that's not what I'm going to use. If you right click on that depth map there, you'll be able to switch it to a normal map. And to be honest with you, I've found that this works better because it's going to give us some definition. If you notice, you could see where the chest muscles are. You could see, better see the definition on the nose, the eyes, the mouth, all that type of stuff. So that's going to make things just a little bit easier for us. All right. And then to the left, there's going to be our prompts. I did zombie guy, gray, scars, negative prompts, blurry, bad quality. And then down here, we got our generate art. If you're having issues with, shadows and glare on your figure, you can generate a background that's, maybe darker or whatever, then that'll influence the lighting. So we hit the generate art button, and this is what we got in the beginning. We got this nice little zombie creature. This is kind of just a base for him. It's definitely low resolution, but we're going to go in there. We're going to fix that. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to go down, and in the bottom left, there's an inpaint tab. We're going to hit that. I keep all of this in the beginning kind of on the default values. And then we went through when I went back in and I painted the mask over the spots that I really want to focus on. And then I also zoomed in on the face. And what that's going to do is, so if we have a 512 by 512 texture that we're putting over this, and if we put it over a whole body, that's going to spread that texture over the whole body and going to make it more low resolution. Whereas like this, it's going to spread it over a smaller surface, which is going to make it a little bit higher resolution. And to make that even better, I switched up. I went width 512, height 768. So that's going to be a little bit bigger texture that's going to go over that. You can also use the refine upscale, and that will honestly improve the textures. But I've got a different trick I'm going to be using for that anyways, so I don't worry about it. All right, so we generated that at 512 by 768, inpainted, and then a little bit closer. And we got much better textures, which we're going to improve even better using another program. All right, and then we're going to go back to the inpaint tab and click auto erase twice. And what that's going to do is it's going to get rid of the mask that we already had there and then allow us to put a new mask. On this one, I just masked off where the original or where the first image of the face didn't get to on the 3D or on the 3D object. And so we're just going to inpaint over just that part. And once we generate that at that 512 by 768, it's going to give us this, which is definitely a lot better. And it actually looks pretty good so far until we turn the face. And for some reason, I'm glad this kind of happened because it allows for the opportunity to show you how to fix this. For whatever reason, it also messed up the texture on this side of the face. And so to fix that, if you get out of the paint or if you get out of the inpaint tab, all of a sudden this will be the mask and the eraser will work for each individual image, which if you notice each of these images right here, that's what's being overlaid, but there's also a mask involved with each one of those to determine how much of the 3D object those images go over. And that's under the art tab, by the way. So what I did is I went in. Oh yeah, here. So I went to, I'm using this image right here because that's the last one. And what we want to do is we want to only use the side of the face and only the part that wasn't already pretty much covered by the front of the face, which is this image right here. And then we hit the eraser. And what I did is I erased all of that, whatever the heck was going on with it, with the texture before. And so now this part is now on that 3D object, as well as the sides are going to have the texture from this right here. All right, so now we have our initial UV map. We have our kind of our establishing shot. We have our close-up on the face, and then we have our side. And obviously, if we were going to like make this official character that we were doing, we would put a lot more effort into it. We'd zoom in on the chest and maybe make that just a little bit more higher resolution. And then we'd also do the sides. Even though if we wanted to, we could, once this is all done, we could just use symmetry to you know, do both sides so we don't have to paint on the left side and the right side.
Oh,
and the next thing we're going to do after that is we're going to save each of these images into a PNG file, and then we're going to upload that. And what I did is I uploaded it to Krea and enhanced each of those images. And so you notice here I have a enhanced version of that side, this one right here. And I loaded this image, the enhanced image, into here. And I did that for each of these. So basically, I have an enhanced version of all three of these images. And I uploaded each of those images, those enhanced images, onto those. So basically, it's replacing each of these. And but it's also keeping the masks that we have. So even though there might be some touch-up we have to do, it'll should be pretty seamless. So now we have the three more enhanced versions of this that are making the character look a little bit better. And then we're going to hit this icon up here, which is going to merge everything together, which is going to give us this. Now, it looks really funky right here. And if we were to go the whole way and like fix the entire thing, if we were going to like finish this project, this would look a lot better because we'd have the face, we'd have the full torso, we'd have the eyes, all the different parts of the texture atlas would be filled in there with the actual textures of the character. But for the purpose of this, we're just going to finish what we have. All right, the next step is we're going to take and we're going to change. There's a plus icon down here. We're going to change it to save 8K. And then we're going to save the project. And that's going to give us this final composition that's going to be at 8K. And then save our whole project so we can come back to it. So now we're back into DAZ and we've got the character here. And we're going to make sure that all of the different parts of the skin that are used in this texture atlas over here are all highlighted. And then we're just going to drag and drop. We're going to drag and drop this into that spot, which is going to give us our new character. And I've got a few different versions or a few different images of him. A little bit more angry here, making him smile a little bit. One of the cool things here, too, is DAZ just improved its filament renders. So that is filament, which took like 2 seconds to render this, whereas, you know, these took, you know, about a minute or so. But anyways, that's the how I'm using this to paint textures on DAZ figures. You can really have a lot of fun with this. And of course, the more work you put into it, the better it's going to look. But anyways, let me know in the comments if you have some better practices for me to use, some ideas, some thoughts, any questions. This Stable Projectorz thing, I was honestly for a while there using Blender to use stencil painting to paint the textures. This makes things so much easier and so much better. I can't believe that this actual program exists. It's absolutely amazing. I'll leave a link in the description below so that you can install Stable Projectorz, and then also a link to another video of somebody did a little bit more in depth on how to use Stable Projectorz, but not on DAZ figures, on other 3D objects. Anyways, everybody have a wonderful day.